Hello kids, I am Priyanka and I'm back again with my new video of class 6, chapter 4, The Old Clock Shop. Christmas Eve had arrived, Christmas ki sham aa gayi thi. Last minute, shoppers were going home. Last minute tha, jo shoppers the, wo ghar ja rahe the. A thick white sheet of snow lay over the Salt Lake City, USA. And the light was still burning in the old clock shop. Ek old purane shop mein, purana shop tha, wo abhi bhi chalu tha. As Ray, it's cold. Yet the lights were still burning in the old clock shop. As Ray's old deaf owner worked on the clock he sold that day. Having finished his work, Ray stood up and was on his way to back room when a cold rush of air from the front door hit the back of his neck. He turned to meet a last minute shopper, but his old wise eyes told him that this was not a shopper. He saw two men, one in his 20s and the other in 50. The younger man remained at the door. Jo younger man tha, wo door ke paas khada hua tha. Jo older man tha, wo approach kar raha tha counter pe. With no sign of friendliness in his eye, Ray was unable to hide his growing fear as he slowly pushed a notepad and a pencil across the counter. He smiled at an unfriendly face, then pointed to his ears and shook his head from side to side. A quick look of surprise changed the man's face and studied the notepad and then turned and said something to him. Ray used to use the chance to look close at the man, paying attention to the shape of the gun and the restless hand in the man's right coat pocket. Anger boiled with him, but it was kept down by the inner voice that said, "Be still." He wrote on the notepad, "May I help you?" Notepad mein likhta hai, "May I help you?" For the first time, the older man looked directly at Ray and smiled, a cruel mocking smile. They both understood why he was there, why his friend remained at the door. They looked like men who were down on their luck and now ready to try something they would later be sorry about. The clock ticked on. Ray calmly wrote another message. "Have you come to pick you up a clock or watch? Kya aap yahan pe koi apni watch ya clock pick karne aaye ho?" Then he pointed to the lone board filled with hanging clocks and pocket watches. He was not a pawnbroker, but at the same time, they could not say no to the needy people who placed their old watches or clock before him for anything that they could get. He loaned more than he should. वो उनको उससे ज़्यादा ही देता था जितना उसको देना चाहिए. They would be there when the owner wanted them back. At the same price, he paid with no interest. Then the old man seemed to feel a quite little easier, took out his hand from his pocket and quickly looked at the watch of his wrist. "How much will you give me for this?" the man wrote. Ray noticed a little shame in his grey eyes looking at him. The watch was nothing special and yet have great power. It was something to exchange, a way out of his bad situation. Knowing that great need had brought the man to his shop in the first place, Ray asked, "How much do you need for it?" The man replied back in the notepad, "What it's worth." Ray reached to his cash box, pulled a $50 note and passed it to the man's hand. They shook hands. Ray looked at the man's eyes. They seemed to say, "Thanks." They both know the watch wasn't worth that much. Before turning to leave, the man wrote, "I'll be back to pick it up as soon as I can. Merry Christmas." The little story ended on a half an hour with the clock striking altogether. The timepiece, which had been looking on silently at a while, rang out of time with such feeling that even Ray thought he would hear them. The sweet musical message was filled with hope, the timeless message of peace on earth, goodwill towards all, was felt by the three men who stood in the old clock shop. Thank you.